He's a good guy. He's trying to get me to freak out like Ed. But I'm not sure.
Because he is Ed.
But I'm not sure.
But I ain't the voice.
I'm not sure!
How's it going, everyone? It is IPC, and if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe, like this video, comment, and share this video wherever you can. I would appreciate that very, very much. Anyways, let's dive into Mighty Aphid for the Nintendo Switch. Developed by Cascade Games and published by Chili Dog Interactive, this is a Mega Man clone game in every sense of the word. You jump and you shoot at enemies, and that's pretty much it. And here's the thing, if you are a fan of old school Mega Man, then this will not be a bad thing at all to you. But if you're looking for something new with this title and unique, then you won't find it here, unfortunately. In terms of story, you play as Aphid, who has to go after the villainous Ladybug, who is raining havoc on the town of Victoria. There are a grand total of 6 levels in this game. 3 are already unlocked and available for you, so you could choose any of those 3 levels to start off with. The other 3 levels are locked, which I assume can only be unlocked by completing the first 3 levels. Now, unlike the traditional Mega Man formula game, in this game you have to save civilians, which there are 6 in each level. Once you save all the civilians, you can finish the rest of the level, and you'll be taken to the boss of that level, where once you beat the boss, you get their special ability for your suit. So, just like in Mega Man, except for the fact that in order to use your special abilities, you have to keep your suit powered up by collecting gems, which they are truly, truly outrageous. Yeah, I just had to throw in that League of Legends reference there, but nevertheless, unlike in Mega Man, where you have to choose the weapon that you want to use, in this game, you already have the weapon already unlocked and ready to use. All you have to do is just collect gems and keep your suit powered up in order to use them. And so far, I've unlocked the Spread Fire ability, as well as the Wing ability, which allows you to fly. So yeah, just like in Mega Man, you have different abilities, and these abilities become useful as you progress through the game. And as you would expect from a game like this, it is really frustrating and really challenging. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, but at the same time, there are a few gripes that I do have with this game. One of the problems I have is the fact that gems and items can get stuck behind walls, which means you can't get to them. And looking at this game, this may play like Mega Man, but it sure as hell does not feel like Mega Man. For one, you do not have post-damage invincibility, which means that if you land on an enemy, you can take extra damage, and that drains your health faster than you could say, "I'm going to die." And while this game does have unlimited continues, the problem is the fact that every time you die, you have to start the level all over again, which means you have to save the civilians again, and you also lose the gems that you collect. And those are some of the issues that I have with this game. Overall, I love the 2D presentation of this game. It makes me feel like I'm playing the older Mega Man games. And the music isn't that bad either. I'd say it's decent and it fits with this game. So all in all, Mighty Aphid is a very average game, and if you are a fan of 2D retro style games, or you're looking for your Mega Man fix, then this might be the game for you. If you would like to purchase this game, I'll have a link to it in the description. It's available on the Nintendo Switch right now for $4.99, which I think is a good price for an average game like this. I'd like to thank Chili Dog Interactive for sending me a review copy of this game, and I look very forward to whatever games they publish next. But nevertheless, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please be sure to leave a comment and let me know what you guys think about this game in the comment section below. And also be sure to subscribe to the channel for more video game reviews such as this. Anyways, this has been PC, signing off. I'll see you guys in the next review.